Of pigs, we had a nutrition rate of 20 to 40%. Very suitable for partners, but it's poor for breeders. In the feeding trial that lasted for 165 days, with the market weight at 90 kilograms, we had a bar fat thickness which was within range and a feed conversion ratio of 2.95 to 1. The cost savings was 4%. Pan carrying in bullets, we have been able to apply pan carrying in bullets, feeding with an attrition rate of about 25%. And the bullets were able to achieve laying at 18 weeks. For the laying beds, we had an attrition rate of 8%, hence the production of 91%, duration at peak, 5 months, that is, the peak, the beds maintain the peak production for 5 months. Egg size was normal, egg shell, normal thickness, the laying period of 18 months, until we achieved 68% when animals were due for calling. The cost saving was 50%. Other ways that we cannot completely. Other ways for us we cannot discuss from here. The main gluten meal, sorghum bran, sorghum grain, rice bran, molasses, poultry byproducts. But we have investigated the use of oil and palm soil in feeds for bullets, pigs, laying beds, and bullets. Now, for feed, because of the nature, the taste, and the taste and the compatible nature of the palm oil, slurry, we restricted our nutrition rate to 15% of bullets, generally in monogastric animals. But for brown bread, we are able to achieve 18 weeks for 2 days at point of play. And while the black bread is able to achieve 17 weeks and 4 days at point of play. Now the weight at play for the black bear was 1.6 kg. And then the weight at play for the brown bear was 1.448 kg. The mortality was less than 1.5%. The cost saving was 18% over a period of 10 weeks. Our tournament was to 94 and Hartmann's for our company. Up to 39% of our business. And this is a major inhibitive factor. It slows your ability to use it freely in feeds. And like I mentioned earlier, three principal ingredients are what we're going to be looking at. Maize, which produces your energy, for your animals. Wheat fats for fiber. The soya and granules for proteins. For rice bran, we have tried to use rice bran to replace wheat fats. Because it is free. The whole idea is to save cost. It is free. But in doing that, you must understand the chemistry. You must know the chemistry of rice bran. It's high in fiber content. It also has the anti-nutrition factors we call phytic acid or phytics. Let me take your time. I will just throw this to see it, but I will give you a real life nutrition report. And in 6 months, the best way laying well, in 6 months, we have lost close to 29,000 eggs. The best way not sick. We had no other challenges, but it was purely nutritional. They were picking mortality in hundreds, 100, 150 every day. And this bear did not start dying until 6 months after laying, because there was a cumulative effect. Now they were using rice bran. In a typical feed formulation, we use it over at 16% nutrition, which is 160 kilograms for laying legs in a ton. But what they did in this farm, they used 160 kilograms in a ton of rice bran. Yes, it was understandable that they had to use rice bran because this farm is located in one of the highest rice producing regions of this country. You can see the information there, 85% crude protein. But except meat to carbonate fed amine, it's a range of 70 to 87%. But we don't have facilities to have less fed. Those who are eating fed right now in this country, imported from Brazil and Argentina, especially the fish farms. So it's a common ingredient in fish feed and in creep feed. Creep feed is the feed you give to pigs that are still nursing. When your pig fouls in litters and the piglets are still sucking, what you want to do is to give them creep feed so you can wean the pig on time. If you have a mother that is lactating about 15 piglets, like Professor Lemon's kid, what you can possibly do, because of the pressure that will be mounted on the mothers, you can introduce creep feed. So with creep feed, you can wean on time to wean your animals at any effort. The traditional weaning period is 4 to 8 weeks. But when you wean your animals at 3 weeks, you can get the animal to litter 5 times in 2 years. And it's all about naira. Otherwise, the whole cycle is 6 months. So the pig will litter twice a year. But if you are using creep feed, the pig will go very well. In 3 weeks, they are big as the normal piglets that will nurse on their mothers for 6 to 8 weeks. And then you can wean them and start breeding them and packing them. And then get the mother to cross to the mother still making her shape. Then get the mother to cross to the baby. So that is the subject. If you want to do that, you can use that baby for cleaning. Because it has to have a very high protein and energy content because of the cholesterol. Once you are 40, the doctors are telling you, don't eat egg. Take once a week. My doctor said I can take one a day. You see, but you know how painful it is for some of us farmers to see over 200 grains of your house every day and you cannot eat one. The mental torture you go through. So science is advancing. We are making progress. We are into cutting egg research right now. And we are in partnership with Agro Farms. Agro Farms is located in our way in other states. The owner of this farm is the president of the poultry association. And she found about 1.5 million birds. And we will farm every week. Dr. Ayo Tuntun is not here. He's a group MD. But he has sent one of his very respected general managers. Standing for him here. Dr. Begore, you are here. Smart and designer eggs. Yeah. And selenium, eggs that are high in omega 3 fatty acids and low in bad cholesterol. But we have challenges because of producing eggs. Which means it was exclusive for the top class Nigerians. So we're not going to transfer the cost to the ordinary man. My partner partnership with Sitamo right now is to explore unconventional field resources to help bring down the cost of producing designer eggs for you. So very soon, even at 70, you can have your eggs freely. You send your child to go and read an agriculture course. We don't want our students to read our children to read agriculture. Or yet, we are the beautiful bride of the economy now. We can't go for it. It is time to take decisions. We cannot for it. Once it's time for admission, my dean is the busiest dean in this university. And not only this university, even if I. He's not busy because he has so many students to admit, because he has no students to admit. He's going around looking for the students that have been rejected in other faculties. And yet, what we see in the nation, we're talking about food security. You can't go far with this. Even when the students come to the culture, when they live here, you see them as cab drivers, they own value salons. Every day, I put up a blue scores looking for workers, trying to work in farm. We don't see them. Let me tell you about my personal experience with one of my former students. I flew into Abuja Airport. I took a car to town to Wuse. And this phone was driving me. And by the time we got to Wuse, he was looking so uncomfortable. So I asked him. Well, I was now, by the time I got to Wuse, I was now thinking that he wasn't going to take me away. But when I either way, I stayed in front of the seat. So I said, my friend, why are you looking so uncomfortable? He said, sorry, sir. You were my teacher in university, sir. You see, you read what? Red and more science. I said, you are driving taxi from Abuja. He said, no job. But we'll still be in Abuja. Well, I succeeded in getting him out of that job and gave him a job in the farm where he's doing so well. And Dr. Abato, the owner of the farm and market, says he's one of his best staff. Mr. Vice Chancellor, sir, permit me to come meet town. Private enterprises such as the commercial team leaders have in recent years recognized the need to collaborate with research scientists with a bid to introduce waste into their fields and bring down costs for the goods. It is debatable who enjoys the benefits of the utilization of waste in creating waste at this level. However, if you have to put the interest of Nigerians on the table, it is inescapable for governments to set up necessary machinery in motion aimed at achieving waste waste at the micro level through private sector driven agricultural policy implementation partnership. Governments' ability to cloud in the private sector have at best yielded minimal sources, except for immediate past agricultural transformation agenda. The value chain approach to agricultural transformation we are lacking. We know for sure that the concept of waste to wealth has been totally absent. Agricultural policies lack successful implementation avenues. Plans to see poor implementation strategy of government to siphon away economic, social, and political growth potentials of our country, Nigeria. We must call on all tiers of government, federal, state, and local government to think outside the box about implementation. On the brain alternative agricultural promotion policy of the present administration, I make bold to say there's a need for shift in implementation. First, let me say that cultural policy promotion must continue to engage the private sector, as key integration partners if we are to see continued successes noted in the month acclaimed as cultural transformation of 2011, for example. Second, our policy foundations and implementers, largely civil servants, must humble themselves to learn from the private sector best practices. We must change from the culture of ill-gotten money sharing to the culture of profit sharing as in the private sector. Thirdly, creating an enabling environment for the private sector to thrive will not only eliminate the high losses of food commodities, but help to increase internally generated revenue, increase import substitution, increase foreign exchange reserves, and most of all, create jobs for the immigrant population and women of this country. Nigeria's agricultural policy and incentives must therefore focus on crowding in the private sector through targeted infrastructure investment, especially in power, water, and roads, for the seamless food ecosystem to be developed in Nigeria. The issue of hunger and nutrition can only be addressed successfully through a thriving agricultural-based economy in Nigeria. Our policy makers must integrate not only agricultural nutrition, but agriculture, nutrition, and education. The school feeding program of Oshunsky is a good example of integration of these three seemingly different policy platforms. Government must work together with our faculties of agriculture and research institutions to strengthen our education, beef and agro-allied industries. As a matter of fact, we must leverage on research to develop agricultural production in the right direction. I'm also bold to recommend that the Agricultural Council of Nigeria should be re-engineered and refocused. All forms of extension services should be developed to the state to make research findings to end users based on the comprehensive revival of the Unified Agricultural Extension System, UAEs, which is based on basic farmers and should cover all areas of agriculture, including agroforestry, fisheries, soils, and water conservation practices. This is presently a serious disconnect in this direction. Governments must also affect access to farmland for young farmers using the farm settlement model. Right now, we're not going to trade. We're talking about recession. But there's no oil. When the opportunities are there in agriculture. And when I addressed the plenary session of the National Conference, I did remember very well. The full scholarship. We also recommended 2-3% for agri loans. Now we are 9% under the provincial cultural credit scheme of CBN. Even that 9% loan is not being assessed by the ordinary farmer. Because the bottlenecks are there to prevent competitors. So the big guys are the ones who get that loan, 9%. They get that loan 9%, they take 4 billion on 9%. And loaning out to money lenders at 60%. And this is what is happening in this country. In the United States, the rates and weights from French fries, French fried cheese, processing and farm gate potato waste are being converted to value added allergy free pet food products. Two simple divination processes. Why then must our cassava be continuously stored inside the ground instead of dehydrating processing to preserve and add value? Perhaps this is because of lack of sufficient private sector investment and the lack of government's incentive to crowd in the private sector. Why government hold its arms? Semovita and whole wheat swallow. These days, you enter a restaurant, you are asking for thermometer or plates. So where is our mother? Where is our fufu? And where is our fufu? Why the mentor is saying thermometer and hope is for those staple foods have taken over our restaurant menus from Pandayam, fufu, and Amara. When wheat is more or less foreign to our culture, sepovita and wheat swallows are made from this. And we call this wheat with our hard-end foreign culture. Except for wheat, which has not become a staple in our diets, but must be imported with our hard-end foreign culture. And wheat swallow products for Nigerian consumers. Same is true for bread and noodles, which are made of wheat, but have become part of our staple foods. Our children will never forever. We be forever hook on these meat-based products. If we fail to create new products from our local staple crops, especially cassava, rice, and beans. Let me assure you that local production of cassava into high quality flour. We help to achieve not only food security, but also nutrition security. I submit that public as well, substitution policy of government for bread making must not be the end point, but a complete ban of feed importation for 100% replacement of high quality and food safety compliant cassava flour should be the end here.
Okay.
Cassava is our best resource of food fortification with the Vice Chancellor, Professor Elima Awo, our Michael Vice Chancellor, who has been in office only recently, but has a short space of time presented himself to all staff of this university as a tireless workhorse, visionary, and bridge builder. Ready to lead a united workforce. I have no doubt, Vice Chancellor, that your set goals will be realized as you are then being endowed with able